turns out there are a lot of women who just have a problem with women in power. You know, this whole sisterhood, this whole let's go march for women's rights, and, you know, just constantly talking about what women look like or what they wear or making fun of their choices or presuming that they're not as powerful as the men around. This presumptive negativity about women and power, I think, is very unfortunate, because let's just try to access that and have a conversation about it rather than a confrontation about it. Most of the strength and the leadership skills and the decisiveness, the resoluteness that I think this country was craving from its president, from a leader, is the same in public as it is in private. I find them to be very kind and generous. I find them to have a great sense of humor. I'm genuinely interested in everybody's lives, their own families, their own pursuits, their backgrounds, their knowledge. He's a man who just absorbs information and people. And so he's very generous, very kind, funny, compassionate. And people should really think about, when they see President Donald Trump, they should think about all the places that he was and could be, all the things he could be doing. The political motivators for many typical politicians, of which he's not one, Mercy, money, power, prestige, fame, he had all of that. And he and his family have sacrificed mightily. Every great movement ends up being a little bit sclerotic and dusty after a time. And I think they need an infusion of energy. And in the case of candidate Trump and president-elect and nominee Trump, he went right to the grassroots and brought you along. He made people feel from the beginning they were part of this movement. And being part of a movement means you're not just witnessing a campaign externally, which is the way I think a lot of activists felt over the years. At different periods of time, which is that they're just witnessing history rather than being a part of it.